Up next, the Supreme Point, live. The rocket young empirical object steals sun from the Zambulian plains. It runs ablaze around a high tensed torso, a worshiper chalking ochre across their baked young skin to let the spirits in when the fire shock ceremony begins. Silver steaming stack of gleaming, keening, star smallering steel. Pre-combustion puffs emote in tight air. The rocket reflects the sky, grand potential in blue. Hundreds nurse their own aspect. Schoolchildren stash compacted popular mechanics magazines in pockets, then excitedly extract them again for the comparing of a cover, inked in blasting jets of orange, yellow, red, with the totem standing passive-aggressive in a deep sea rhythm of whitely sparking field glasses.
Countdown. A hell of chemistry. Hell of a noise. This bird can fly. Earth gravity clear. Supreme point coming into range. And view. Can see something. Countdown. A hell of physics.
The rapture and sublimity of thin gravity dividing into polygons. Strings of lilac. Dandy roses red. The fancy and genius of slow space crew reaching beyond their forwards and phases. Raising hands to the Big Bang. This is it, love. This is it. The seraphic and infinity of we're always in afternoon, we dare not stop. Of the monument mournfully tumbling as vast objects slow do always great seem mournful. The bliss and divinity of feeling the heat closing in. After some digestion neither of us feel. The euphoria and gnosis of programming and metaprogramming in the human biocomputer when spring is here to tell you hurry.
The rocket negotiated budget manifestation is assembled in sections off location, travels thoughtfully, Senator upright, to the charred launch pad built sudden in the charmed glassy sands which believed they were the unknown heavens, until structures set down girdered feet, began talking of nothing but up, straight as light, silvery as a cascade of coins, comes on a motorized platform through the poor country at barely any speed. Skinwalkers, weird scenes, lost nieces, canyons with howls running backwards to gray hackled dogs. Roads barred by a cavalcade of cops who wear snapping black gloves, who point. Background newsreel crowds hold cardboard signs of dislocated triumph. The rocket parades disassociated, looking away.
I am, seems to, be a large aircraft below 5,000 tons. I cannot affirm. It is four bright. It seems to me like landing lights, unknown due to the speed it's traveling. Is there any Air Force aircraft in the vicinity? Black satellite signal indicates range. Out, out. 5060. Out Supreme Point. Possible. You're a little breakdown.
The rapture and sublimity of consciousness, blue, pale, I am across streets being cremated. Of come true, Alice painting roses red to be Davy Jones. The fancy and genius of everywhere, stars in the cabin below. Burning, excited, turning, exalted. The seraphic and infinity of someday in the golden afternoon, merrily, merrily. It wasn't always like this, the pilot thinks. The bliss and divinity of hyperstition as on Earth, so in Heaven, is that a Breton reference? Neither of us is clear. As is improbable, so is imagined. The euphoria and gnosis of space crew goddess and perception vast.
The rocket is obsessively monitored. Every instrumental output quick sent for diagnostic opinion to a climate condition central control. Puffs of pre-combustion snort rough in cracking ancestor arid desert air. Commander Anastasia regards her rows of engineers. In turn, they watch panels of registering signals. Radar green blips scanning the sky. Needles gentle dowsing like the antennae of blind insects navigating crawl space. Telemetric displays occulting chaos. Constrained rainbows of telling lights. Constant dialogue between the square room and fuel shivering arrow 5 km away. Commander Anastasia flicks a switch. Initiates a countdown.
That he's playing some sort of game. He's flying over me too, three times at a time, at speeds I could not identify. Roger. What is your actual level? My level is 4,500. 4500. Nose thrusters burn 2 seconds. Under thrusters burn 1 second. Under thrusters.
capture and sublimity of the space crew are feedback of previous space crew. The fancy and genius of seeing stars moving deeper like pi after the monumental decimal. Everything is numbers in tumbling evocation. The seraphic and infinity of new tons of reality estate falling between astronauts. Of fear watched from a comfortable distance, eating into the frozen normal fully. The bliss and divinity of fantasia inside the pilot's head, an interiority of sakra, the euphoria and gnosis of the pirate's life. With a high and ho, we're gonna waste the drop.
The rocket is not the product of biology, the subject not the stuff, but the progeny of maths, chemistry, parallel to mystical particle physics. Stacking of midnight benzedrine jazzed calculations on Pasadena blackboards that engineers run the hijinks length of. Racking of moonlight brains half melted by a dream, burnt Caltech laboratory benches, lunacy landscapes of lists, scraps, sketches, thin-skinned plans, fuels for stratosphere, projectile summits, gyroscopes and gas, water-cooled nozzles, solid-state patents, mad young men and their stabilizing veins, Jack Parsons died for our sums, Everett timelines hacking blueprint paper, space lines graphing inevitable combustion, and slick homogeny of bustling thrust.
Sublimity of the farfadets when all sad and done, when all saints and him. Scents of black hole mucus, gravity waves frying in the sands our ship sailed to. The fancy and genius of many a tear we shed, little star. Where is the crescent? Mainframe wild lore, thickets of subroutines and unused commands flustering in circuitry shadow work. The seraphic and infinity of whales breaking ice, broken ships sinking, singing into dark brine rap. The bliss and divinity of morning glories twinkle, twinkle. Tomorrowland will be the greatest TV special ever built. Just you watch. The euphoria and gnosis of becoming more clear after some digestion. The space crew are feedback. Moon awake, there's a smile in your heart.
The rocket erected photographs well. Anything with fins does. Sharks in the car James Dean wrecked his neck in. Against sky blue enough to derange horses grimacing with thirst, photographers arrange an intimacy of stark blank and shining edge. They shoal around the launch pad, looking for the perfect periodical sail of a remarkable future, vision then materialized in reflection, steel and aerodynamic everything that is as much echo of pulp sci-fi paperback wrapper art, stranging rockets colonizing moons, bursting through eyeballs of deep black void, cheap trash books churned out by hacks, the necessary flight design, the outward urge, exiles on Asperus, derelict of space, and the supreme point.
It's not an aircraft. It is open. Delta Sierra Juliet. As it's flying past, it's a long shape. Cannot identify more than that. It has such speed. Last known supreme point.
The rapture and sublimity of saccharine ethereal choirs in the animated films they used to show. The fancy and genius of neither feels certain of what actually happens in the poem after our first read. And now we're so many years away, the seraphic and infinity of knowing whether the big chafe moon can see your pleading. The bliss and divinity of blowing minds together as the hypnagogic drive fires up. A council of evolved kelp darkened into existence as if on a photographic plate. The euphoria and gnosis of lizard brain cycles dropping cluster bomb hard beyond underneath every flight snuff space crew cut. Do I hear 21?
The rocket locked hatches and pressure sealed inlets waits like a jar of mummified ibis in an Egyptian dignitary's tomb. Waits like a desperate swallowed quaalude, a bullet caught in a magician's mouth. Waits like a foxglove nodding itself numb. It waits nib-like, as if ink-rich, ready to transcribe a gospel or madrigal or dumb medieval proclamation. Like an artificial limb for the shocked amputee, the rocket is a taut metal wound healed over and waiting for radiant health. waits like a chrysalid, a bubo, a chestnut gall full of pulsing wasp, waits like a bottle, cast from a bloom of fearful twisting rigging into the sea.
Security communication. Can you read that on the scale? Yes, sir. We're now on the 5/10 scale, and we're reading about third, fourth makeover. Okay, Security 6. Have a light all with gas, please. Scale reading SP.
The rapture and sublimity of First Officer Weir, a Boltzmann brain who has suddenly popped into resistance. Usual initial question, who am I questioning? The fancy and genius of people cannot see over our way, we're only sure. Sundorn writes the canyon with blank-faced government agency triumph. The seraphic and infinity of taking a stress pill, thinking things over. The bliss and divinity of no better time to start when the second star on the right is painting the space through roses. Richard Dad hears you thinking and looks up from his bedlam easel in surprise. The euphoria and gnosis of honeycomb halls, populated with celestial jesters who push back, giggling, it's not your time yet.
The rocket, we're told, has had final checks, and Zambulian ground crew have departed just a moment ago to recap weather reports, wind comfortably within safety parameters. All signs indicate we're on schedule. On this historic day, I can tell you this launch is being syndicate broadcast in 137 countries, watching right now on this momentous day. If our camera looks beyond Highway 5 used to transport the rocket, it'll see a glint of windscreens lined up on the perimeter. That's thousands of sightseekers traveling hundreds of kilometers to be here on this remarkable day. And we're told the space crew have made the customary last-hour naming of their capsule, calling it Custa Ben Luca.
The meter's definitely giving a little pulse. You're reading the clicks. I can't hear the clicks. That about the center, Bruce? Okay, let's go to the center. That's the best deflection of the needle. We're on the 0.5 scale, at approximately a 1.25 hours. We're getting right at a half of a millirem at the supreme point.
The rapture and sublimity of carrying our familiars with us. Millions of miles away from home, too. The fancy and genius of monks half-handedly pleading in mounting violet mist. The seraphic and infinity of every emergent color the supreme fascist thought to formula. The bliss and divinity of them that streaks across. Am I my pale blue consciousness, asked the astronaut. The euphoria and gnosis of Zener cards, sea wave lines, DNA circles, perspectival triangles, hashish courtyard squares, of spooling action at a bliss dance.
The rocket is phallic, no question about it. One thick control center cocked, priapic steely gun waiting to be shot. To slide between the plump sky and into the vast irradiated yoni of interstellar space. Don't need no psychologist's read on the call of the penis to believe the entrepreneurs and government's creed of propagating the human seed. Their starish multiplication of the species comes from iridescent adolescent dreams of seeing their jism cross the face of reality. Which leads to the query, would a matriarchy have created the rocket, or something more vaginal, perhaps a portal, a permanent tunnel, two-way journey to total mystery? Hell, maybe the sapphics wouldn't want to leave.
Personnel requesting, tell them negative, have them cut it off, is between indentation 2 and 3 about 5 feet away, put it in here, I've got some more, crystalline, supreme point.
The rapture and sublimity of lions a roving over the sea, she'd raise her voice to the hillside, of dead space crew gulping enormous for coherence. The fancy and genius of dreaming that you dream, shining in the night, for the golden afternoon. If the bones there get up, the seraphic and infinity of that ash too, in thought. Turning monologue, the ship's captain becomes running brains. The bliss and divinity of fracturing astronaut jacked into and off by an extensive redacted cryptozoology database. The euphoria and gnosis of sharing the cabin with human individual metamorphosis. Total overcomers, anonymous chugging Kesey's soft drinks. A pirate's life is a lot of things from the flowers.
The rocket's interior, commissioned from a leading Scandinavian architectural practice, is designed to blend superior space crew comfort with optimum intuitive utility. Literally a machine for living in. A psychologically sensitive palette of black and white and accents of hot silver and deep marine digital spatial illumination. Art Deco pellet portholes in conversation with minimalist spectral details across key mission productivity stations. Flight furniture subtly upholstered in self-repair, mycelium fiber woven in serene patterns envisioned by an AI artist represented in major museums and blue chip collections.
They'd like to use the Omni. I'll leave it in SLU. I've got good signal strength in SLU. Okay? Your ADS and PGNS agree. Very closely around. Use angles. Our position checks downrange. Show us to be a little long. Getting a little fluctuation in the AC voltage. Now, Delta H is minus 2,900. I'll go at 4. Give us a read. Same alarm. You can feel it in here when it throttles down. Better than the simulator. 16, 68, up, ping and pitch, minus 9, yaw, plus 18. F, descent looks good. Supreme point coming up.
The rapture and sublimity of the dreams you plan the tiger lilies love, the dandy roses red, no happy forever. The fancy and genius of a mind, gray-faced and subsisting on scraps of unjointed image, dust and guitars. The seraphic and infinity of sanity is a habit, a voice not quite not there, uncolored, happy as ghosts. The bliss and divinity of my aware of aware becoming my brain's running monologue. The euphoria and gnosis of suggestions from the eggheads back on Earth, something to focus on. We've got to be there if she saw white instead of the golden wonderland thing.
The rocket in the eyes of the stop girl is so slow and so unimaginable, like the city had come to them for once down the big dirt route skirting the rumbled town. Maybe it was a sliding grain silo of a strange foreign farmer she should fear. Maybe a nightmare fish gill-preaching air from centipedal throne of 16 wheels. In the dust eyes of the distant girl, the rocket is a blind faith invasion. She'll talk her life away in an amazed ever about what she saw when small. Tell her roadside children about the day. Tell their roadside children about the day. The only day she ever had unlike the others, when the rocket stopped her. Made its sovereign journey past her edge, the herding of a solitary god.
Captain, we've lost contact with ZM control on this trajectory supreme point position coming up in 12. Okay, keep trying. ZM, hold course. Plot 0.9 gyre on Deja. Captain, ZM contact reestablished. Have relayed current position. Supreme point in 5.
The rapture and sublimity of mist in the rigging and ropes are woven ropes all the way down. The fancy and genius of vying heavy for place in the glorious midnight mass of colorless space. The seraphic and infinity of far fidei when all sails and ships. This is the psychonauts' smooth world. The bliss and divinity of where the path that moonbeams make to nowhere at all. The euphoria and gnosis of my prince coming happiest just behind anywhere. Was he big and wonderful in life?
The rocket, fixed in the magnetic eyes of desert birds, doesn't dervish. It landmarks stretched plains defined by horns of low mountains feverishly distant. A still new rock, undancing and heavy in the illness of lifelessness. The birds are frenetic between the moon and slither. They use this recent certain presence to locate and navigate their sacred flight lines from eggborne on shears to hunting grounds of frantic, tensing rodents, liverish gods. And the rocket is an imposter, but sun in shame and betrayal of settled land plays tricks across this synthetic upcrop as if machine and ancient can dream. Song in goetic reconstruction. The birds wheel in days of mechanized dust, sensing strange glints in their map of here.
Countdown. A hell of chemistry. Hell of a noise. This bird can fly. Earth gravity clear. Supreme points coming into range and view. Can see something. Countdown. A hell of physics.
The rapture and sublimity of dizzy daffodils on wings they never bury. The fancy and genius of nausea tumbling over. No end to the hypnagogia. the seraphic and infinity of the stone slinking sexually into dark brine wrap, of adventurers floating like dead dreams discarded at the suisun side morning, the bliss and divinity of standing at the window of the anchorite cell of the astronaut's mind, the euphoria and gnosis of after some digestion the space crew are so beautiful, it escalates.
Deep snakes.